The goal is to empirically study dog behavior, cognition, and everything else in between, how they interact with us as humans, how we love them, how they relate to wild dogs, everything. We do all sorts of problem-solving games, so fun things like this, where you get to work for food, but he actually gets to test out his brain skills. So we're working on reversal learning tasks, visual discrimination tasks. Are dogs susceptible to visual illusions? We're working on a training game, so what kind of training is effective for learning? How dogs spatially navigate around surroundings, and those are just the ones that we're doing this summer. So we have a whole new set of studies coming this fall. The biggest challenge is trying to systematically study dogs. So when we do scientific experiments with the dogs and studies, we want to make sure that everything stays very similar, stays the same, stays controlled. But dogs, like humans, are very individual. So some dogs learn in a certain way, others behave in a different manner, some have funny quirks, and so you kind of have to adapt. So we have this happy medium between making sure that the dogs that come in have a really good time, that they enjoy what they're doing, but that we're also making sure that we're being very clear about our scientific methods, and that sometimes that can be a challenge. We're open. The biggest accomplishment for the Dog Center is that we've had great success in our first couple of weeks of being open, and the New York City dog community has been exceptionally welcoming and has been a part of our opening. And we've welcomed a variety of different dogs, large, small, with all sorts of backgrounds, all sorts of histories, and they're enjoying coming here and they're coming back, and that's probably our biggest accomplishment.
So what the study is, we teach the dog to discriminate between two toys. So under one toy, we'll always have a treat. And then once they figure that out, then we reverse it on them. So that's why it's called like a reversal study. So then, for example, if the crocodile was the one we taught them that had a treat, once they figure that out, we're gonna put it under the other toy and see how long it takes them, either how long it takes them to figure it out, or if they ever figure it out, or if they like switch strategies. So whatever they do when we change the task on them.
The future plans are to continue our research, and so we're working right now on a whole host of different projects with different collaborators, with different students, but we don't foresee that changing. So we hope that in the future we'll be continuing our experiments, learning more about New York City dogs, in particular, how they navigate the streets of town, how they do with noises, how they do with training, do they see illusions? Are potentially New York City dogs better than other dogs? Who knows? Maybe we'll figure these kinds of things out. That they love us. Yeah.